Hello, welcome to Lumina Nails. In this video, I'm going to show you a sort of unboxing and review of a Modelones kit I bought recently. I bought it because my old lamp, which was a Beetles lamp, died. The cord on it somehow managed to basically shred. It seemed like it was cut, probably because I pulled on it too hard or something. And the lamp died, but I had it for 3 years, and it was a pretty good lamp. But I decided to buy a Modelones lamp because it was cheaper, basically. And I have a lot of new Modelones nail polishes, and I wanted to see if the Modelones lamp made a difference. So this is the Modelones lamp. It's about an inch shorter than the Beetles lamp on the inside. So the inside is pretty thick, with only about an inch to an inch and a half of space inside of it, which is like about 3 or so centimeters high on the inside. So when you put your hand in and it's on a flat surface, it's only about an inch and a half or 3-ish centimeters off the surface that it's on. But the lights are bigger in here, and it seems to work better. I was wondering if it would cure the Modelones better than the Beetles gel, because I've always had difficulty curing Modelones. Even if I paint it incredibly thin, I've always had difficulty curing them in the Beetles lamps. So it says that this is supposed to have like 50,000 hours or something like that, like 5 years of a lifespan. The plug is on this side, which is nice because the plug is on the back of the Beetles lamp, and it's sort of difficult to keep that plug in place. This does open up on the back, so there is like an edge, which means like you can accidentally slide your hand out all the way. The only negative I would say about this lamp so far, because I have used it a couple times, is it doesn't have the on and off function that the Beetles lamp has, and you can't alter the auto on. So when you slide your hand in, it does turn on automatically, like the Beetles lamp and like many other lamps. But you can't change it. Like with the Beetles lamp, you can say 30 seconds, click on it, and it will keep it at 30 seconds when you put your hand in, and it automatically turns on when it's sensored on. Here it just goes for that 90 seconds no matter what, or I haven't found a way to change it. I will say though that the cord seems better quality because it's a thicker cord here. The Beetles cord was the double wired cord, and one of them was severed, one of them was broken, and that's why it stopped working. But this is one pretty good solid cord. It's also very light, so if you like to take this with you or carry it around, this is a pretty light lamp, so it's pretty convenient. It cures really, really, really well. I have had no major issues with it so far. It cures the Modelones better than the Beetles has. So you get the lamp in the kit. I paid $22 and tax with it. One of the kits was like 35, one was 40 something, but this was the cheapest one, and all I really needed was a lamp. But I didn't want to spend $30 on a lamp that I had never or from a brand I had never used before, so I went with Modelones just to be safe. So if you're a beginner or you're somebody who's doing this at home, this would be a good kit. And if the kit is still available, I'll leave it in the description box for you. So besides the lamp, what you get in this kit is 12 colors, 3 gels that are like the base coat, top coat, matte top coat, and some extras. So here's some of the extras. You get these. There are 3 sizes, I believe, of actual like crystal glass AB rhinestone flatbacks in here. Then here you have the little goodies that come in it. These 3 are butterflies. This is butterflies with a glitter. This is a mixed glitter, and these are gold flakes. So these 2 are translucent. So there's a clarity sort of to them, but this one turns purple and blue and green and yellow. Some a little pink in the butterflies, but they're iridescent. And then these ones are yellow, and they turn green and orange. Let's see if I can show you. Can I? There we go. And these ones are solid, so they're not transparent. They're opaque, and they're blue, and they shine a multitude of colors. This one is like an orangey, tangerine-y, sort of corally color. Butterflies in there. And there's some iridescent white glitter inside. And this is like a pink and a rose gold glitter, multiple sizes again. I'm sorry, I have the light off to like this side over here, and that's why the reflection's coming. And then this is just gold foil. So in addition to that, you get the normal like little catalog in here showing the products and Amazon basically. And then this is the normal little pamphlety thing that comes in all of the gel polishes telling you how to use it and how to remove it. And all the other little extra goodies came in this bag when it comes to nail prep and care. And then the glitters came in this bag, and the polishes, the top coat, base coat, and matte coat came in this padded bag. We have top coat, base coat, and matte. So this is the matte top coat, and it's a really good matte top coat. I highly recommend this one if you're looking for one that leaves like no texture to it. Here's a little example nail that I made with some of the colors that were in there, and there's like no like texture at all. I don't know if you hear, but it's sort of like squeaky because there's no residue at all. Very nice matte coat. So you got the matte coat, the base coat, and the top coat. And for reference, these are 10 milliliters or 0.33 fluid ounce, and this is the full size of 15 millimeters, which is 0.5 fluid ounce. The only difference that I've noticed is with the brush. So the bigger size and the littler size. So the little size has like this applicator, which is like my favorite applicator, and the bigger size has this applicator, which is just your standard applicator. So side by side, we see the different styles of applicators here. And of course I prefer this one, but I mean, I'm happy with anything, really. This is a good top coat. So I didn't realize that the matte came in here too, so it's a good set to have if you're trying out the matte coat. I will note that the top coat is gold, the base coat is silver, but with the matte coat it's also silver, so you won't get that color. You know, just by grabbing the gold or grabbing the silver, you won't know which one you're grabbing because of the matte. So just be on the lookout for that one. So we have these like fairy stickers or decals, and then they have like little butterflies on here. They're iridescent. And then some silver and some gold tape that came along here with it. So a lot of variety here to make a lot of different nail designs. Then we have some of the nail care goodies that came in that big bag. So we have the cuticle revitalizer oil, and this is rose scented. Doesn't want to come out. And it looks like this. It's one of those little like twist up ones. It's rose scented. I'm not really big on rose scented, but it is a very nice cuticle oil. Then we have a buffer, which is 600 3000 grit, so one to like shine up your nails. And then your standard 100-180 grit, so a nice good filing block. Then you have your other little goodies in here. The nail brush, you know, to brush off to clean your nails. This tone separator here. And this is nice too because like I go through these a lot, I lose these a lot, so just having those to come in it is just a really nice addition to the set. And lastly, for the nail care goodies, there is a little brush. You can brush off the like excess. It's a very soft brush, very nice. So you can brush off the excess from the filings. Standard nail clipper just, you know, for regular fingernails, which is, I cannot find mine anywhere. And then here you have the cuticle remover, and this one's really nice. If I could find the one that I have over here for reference, like, this is one of those sharpened ones, like the one I already have, which is also sharpened, but on the other side you can see it's sort of different. So this is the one that I have, that's why it has a little acetone stuff on the end of it, but this is the difference. So see, this one is blunt on this one, and this one is sharpened, so it helps to remove the gel. See, so it scrapes off, but I would say, like, just be extra careful with this one because it is sharp. And comparison, like, this one's pretty blunt, so if you, like, slip, it won't necessarily hurt. It won't really, like, damage you horribly, while the other one might actually cause some real damage. So these are the polishes that it comes with. It comes with three glitters, and then the rest are mattes. And then there's, like, three of sort of every kind here. So it's, like, three grays with a silver glitter, three browns with a brown glitter, and then three pinks with a pink glitter. It's a really nice assortment. They are the 7 milliliters or 0.24 ounce ones. And I did already swatch them. These nails are done with these two over here. Let me get them out. So these two colors with 0521 and 0523. I did my nails already with, and this is only one coat of this solid color and one coat of this glitter color. So you can see here, that's the color. It's more of a redder brown in real life than it is on the camera. The camera just picks it up as like a more neutral sort of washed out brown. And then this one is a sort of a brown undercoat with silver glitter. It doesn't look like it's silver glitter, but it is silver glitter, surprisingly. And then same with what I said a little while ago. I did this with all three of the grays and the silver glitter, the clear glitter. And it was only one coat of the bottom gray, and then just like swiping on the other colors, almost like dry brushing on this nail and using the matte top coat. So I will get out the nails, and this is my Modelones ring of colors. So we have up to where we have here. Okay, so here are all the colors that are swatched. We have the first four here, and these are all done with two coats. The lightest one sort of needed three, but I feel like that was fine enough. So we have 0523, 0521, 0527, and 0594. Then here are the pinks. And the pink is also a silver glitter. And they are all with two coats. This lighter one really needed three, but I stopped at two. So this is 0111. This is 0007. 0054 and 0017. So those are all of the pinks. And then lastly, we have the grays with the sort of holographic silver glitter here. And these are once again with two coats. I think they all did pretty well on two coats. I wouldn't add a third one. I think I only did one on this because it seemed like it didn't really need a second coat. But we have 0573, 0602. 0612 and then 0614. So these are all the colors, and in the lab none of them created any, you know, wrinkling or caused any problems. In comparison, when I swatched my gray set of model ones in the Beetles lab, I did get some issues. Let me see. Okay, there, you can see that sort of wrinkling there, wrinkling on this one. There's a lot of wrinkling that went on. If there were any negativities, I would just say that it doesn't have that auto off, auto on function. Also, when it comes to this, like, putting your hand in, because of that smaller space, I can't get the entire nail display inside of it. So it stops, like, part of it. It stops right here. Like when I slide it in, that's as far as it can go in. And then it hits the top and it won't cure. So I do have to remove the little stand and slide that in separate. But I mean, I did that in the Beetles lamp too, so it's not that difficult. But I would say that it's just more of the like, height that is causing an issue than anything. But I do see it as like it does cure really well. It is more compact. While the Beetles lamp did take up a lot of space, so if you're looking for something that's a little smaller, this is good. It cures very quickly. I've used it on 30. I always go 60 seconds for final top coat just to be extra safe, but it does seem to be working well. And I think there's a stand that you can buy to raise the height of this, but it's easy. You just find some things that like you can put some stuff on, even if you just like these little buffer blocks, if you just like position them right and it raises it up enough, and I can slide this underneath it no problem. So it's just all about that height preference, but I do like that it's nice and light. But otherwise, no issues. I think it's a cute set. It's a great little thing to have on hand. Eventually I'll try to get like a good lamp, you know, something that is nicer and has a better height to it. But for now, this is something I'm pretty happy with. So that is the video. My lamp died, so I needed a new one. I couldn't go without it, and that one did me well. So we'll see how long this one lasts, and we'll come back to it if it doesn't last that long. So if this was useful, thank you for watching. I hope that it was useful, and I'm happy if you do find it useful. Once again, link will be in the description box to Amazon. It will be Amazon.com, just like basic Amazon US, because that's where I'm at. And if I can find the $22 one and it's still available, I'll put that in the description as well. And it's a really cute set. I think it came with some fun stuff too. Also, this one is a very good like neutral set for anyone. If you're somebody who maybe has a hard time finding colors that match your skin tone, I'm like a very very pale olive, and Model Ones always seems to look pretty good on my skin tone. I never seem to get any funky or weird discoloration on my skin whenever I wear Model Ones. Sometimes when I put other colors on, I get some really weird blotchiness, or like it creates this weird pigment concentration at my knuckles, but I don't get that with Model Ones. It's a nice true neutral brand. But if you do have issues with Model Ones, just you know, just putting it out there, if there's a curing issue you have, make sure to use very very thin coats, as thin as possible, and just build that up. Otherwise, I think it's a good kit. So thank you for watching. Bye bye.